Upgrading Automation Direct's GS3 Variable Frequency Drive firmware takes three simple steps. 1. Get the hardware and software and install the USB driver for the hardware. 2. Connect to the drive. And 3. Run the upgrade utility. At the end of the video, we'll also go over some troubleshooting tips. Now, before we get started, I want to encourage you to back up the drive parameters. This firmware upgrade procedure doesn't overwrite any of the drive parameters, but why risk it when it only takes a couple of seconds to back up the parameters to the keypad? Chapter 3 of the user manual tells you how to do that. The cool thing about this is you can use one master keypad to update all of your drives, and since the keypad's always there, you're guaranteed to have a backup solution handy. You can also use the free GSoft utility along with this USB to 45 cable to configure and backup the drive parameters. You can find that free software on the downloads page of the Automation Direct website. GSoft is nice because you can see all of the parameters at a glance, bring up a schematic of the drive, and even tune the PID parameters. Finally, make sure you're running Windows 7, 8, or 8.1, 32 or 64-bit versions. And of course, you'll have to be logged into the PC as the administrator to install and use the firmware upgrade utility. Here we go. Step 1. Set up the hardware and firmware. The firmware upgrade board and the USB cable are free. Contact Automation Direct's returns department and request the GS3 firmware upgrade kit. Download the file with the USB driver and firmware update. If you click on the button at the end of this video, it'll take you right to this web page so you can download this file. It has everything you need to do the upgrade, the firmware update, and the driver for that USB adapter board. Unzip or extract the files to a convenient location on your hard drive. Don't use the files directly from the zip folder. I know Windows will let you do it, but it won't work right. We need clean, unzipped files on the hard drive. I'll put mine in a GS3 folder on my C drive just so they're easy to find. Now that we have the files, install the USB driver for the adapter board that we're going to use. Run this x64 file if you have a 64-bit machine, or run this file if you have a 32-bit machine to install the USB driver. Again, make sure you have administrator privileges before installing this driver. Windows won't let you go forward if you don't. Now before we get started, turn on the drive and note which firmware version it currently has. That's in parameter 939. If the drive has version 106, then you have the most recent version and you don't need to go any further. If you have firmware version 104 or 105, which is pretty much every drive sold over the last 10 years, then continue on with this procedure. If you have something earlier than 104, then don't use this procedure. Instead, contact Automation Direct's returns department and they'll get you squared away. Make sure the drive is not powered and then remove the keypad. If this red power LED is still lit, the drive still has potentially dangerous voltages on it. Wait for that light to go completely out. Remove the drive cover and locate the 2x6 female header. Now there's three different controller boards used in the different size drives, but there's only one 2x6 female header like this one on each controller board. And they all have this little white number 1 marking where pin 1 is on the header. The adapter board has this little white triangle marking pin 1. You want to insert this USB adapter board so the pin 1 markings align. Here's what the adapter orientation should look like for the smaller drives. And here's what it should look like for the medium drives. And here's what it should look like for the larger drives. Double check to make sure the connector isn't off by a pin or a row. It's really easy to do. Connect the USB cable between the PC and the adapter. Make sure there aren't any hubs, laptop docking stations, port replicators, or any other device between the PC and the adapter. Turn the adapter's power switch on. You should see at least one green LED light up on the controller board, depending on which size GS3 drive you're using. This switch applies the USB 5 volts to the controller card in the drive, and that's all the power we need. If you turn the drive's power on, it'll also try to drive the 5-volt bus, which will confuse everything. So don't turn the drive power on during this upgrade. If the LED didn't light up when you flipped that switch, then check that the adapter's oriented correctly. If not, fix it and keep going. It should still work fine. Well, now we have to wait for Windows to recognize the new device and install the driver. This can take several minutes, so be patient. When you see the device appear in a device manager like this, you know it's done and ready to use. Great. We've got the firmware and hardware set up and the drives connected. All that's left to do now is update the firmware. Before doing that, go to your device manager and note which COM port the firmware upgrade adapter is connected to. We'll need that in just a minute. It's important to remember that this COM port assignment can change every time you reconnect the USB adapter, so check it each time you use it. If you see any warnings here, disconnect the USB cable and reinstall the adapter driver. Be sure to disable any screensavers and power management features that you may have enabled. We don't want anything to interrupt the download process. Run one of the executables that we unzipped earlier. If your drive currently has firmware version 104, then run this one that says 104. My drive currently has firmware version 105, so I need to run this one that says 105. Now be careful here. If you choose the wrong one, you'll turn your drive into a very expensive paperweight, and there's no way to recover from it. So please, make sure you choose the right executable for your current firmware version. It's like the COM port that we just found a minute ago. If you don't see the COM port, close this software and run it again. Sometimes it takes Windows a while to fully recognize the COM ports, and if you launch this software before Windows is ready, then you won't see the COM port. Press this button to start the download. Don't unplug or even bump the USB cable during download. We don't want anything to interfere with the download. But if the process does get interrupted, just close the utility and restart it. Once it's done programming, the utility will also verify that the upgrade was done correctly. That'll also take a while. When you get the completion message, hit OK, turn the adapter off, unplug it, replace the cover, and replace the keypad. Done. When you power up the drive, parameter 939 should now show firmware version 106. Now, if the upgrade fails for some reason, or the download hangs, or you see a message like this, check the following. Make sure the adapter board is oriented correctly and that the pins aren't off by a row or a column. It's easy to do. If they are, don't panic, just reposition the adapter and start over. Make sure the USB connection is not going through any hubs, docking stations, port replicators, etc. We want a clean shot between the PC and the adapter. Make sure the LED on the adapter is on when the power switch is on. Make sure that one or more LEDs on the drive's control board are on when the adapter switch is on and connected to the PC via USB cable. Make sure the device manager shows no errors or warnings for the adapter. If it does, disconnect the adapter from the USB port and try reinstalling the driver. Make sure you're using Windows 7, 8, or 8.1 on either 32 or 64-bit machines. This utility isn't supported on any other platform. Make sure you're logged in as administrator. And once all of these things have been verified, try running the software again. And of course, if you get stuck, call Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help you. Just make sure you try all of these things first, because that's the first question they're going to ask you, so you might as well save yourself some time.